I have 5 tips for you today on how to act around your ex, but I also have some extra tips that will be really helpful when you see him, so stay until the end of this video to get those extra tips. But before that, it's really important that you take our quiz to find out what your chances are of getting back with your ex. So hop over to exboyfriendrecovery.com or check the description below and take that quiz. It's a 2-minute quiz and it will help you figure out what your chances are of getting back with your ex. The first tip I have for you today is to act indifferent around your ex. And what I mean by that is act like the breakup didn't bother you. Anything that he says just rolls right off your back. You don't have to worry about anything, like you're carefree and your life is even better than it was before. And my second tip is don't bring up anything about the breakup or the past. He may bring it up himself, so what I recommend is bringing a couple stories just in your head, think them up before you go so that you can redirect him. You don't want to fight with him after not seeing him after no contact because you finally reset things. So bring a couple stories, don't bring up the past, and things will go more smoothly. And my third tip is don't be mean. I know that seems silly and so easy to do, but in the actual situation, if your ex brings up another woman or another man, you have to react indifferent and just act like you don't. It doesn't even bother you. Look at your watch, be bored, go to the bathroom, do anything to avoid that fight, because he or she's trying to get a reaction out of you. They want to know they still have you. So after all that no contact, that means it worked, and he's or she is trying to get that reassurance. Don't give it to them. And my fourth tip is don't be too nice, but you still need to be a little bit flirty. So I know that's a little bit contradicting and it seems hard to do, but it's something that my husband writes extensively about and he calls it the push-pull method. So we'll link to that in the description below. There's a whole article on it. But don't be too nice. Don't act like you're still obsessed with him or her. You just gotta act a little flirty, but just not too much. Okay, here's an example. I'm gonna pretend I'm you, and this is what you're gonna say to your ex. Oh, hey, those pants look so good on you. Are they new? So what that does is plants the seed in their head that you're still attracted to them, and there's a hint of underlying sexuality there. But it's not over the top. It's not like, oh my God, I miss you so much and I love you. No, 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 no. Just a little bit of flirting. And my fifth tip is don't ask if they've been thinking about you. That's just gonna come off obsessive and a little crazy. And if they do, it will just come out naturally anyway. Thank you for making it to this part of the video. And as I promised, I'm gonna give you some extra tips for when you see your ex. So you want to appeal to your ex's senses. You wanna feel good, look good, and smell good. The females that are watching this, I want you to wear the color red because it's scientifically proven that men find the color red more attractive. If you're a male watching this, I want you to wear the color black because it's really mysterious and seductive. However, if you cheated on either end, you need to wear the color blue. I have a whole video explaining the science of colors and I'll link to that below. You want to smell really good around your ex, and the best way to do that is wear a cologne or a perfume that they loved when you were together. It'll bring up those fond memories instead of any negative ones. My final extra tip is wear something really soft. In either case, male or female, if they touch you, hug you when you meet them, you want to feel good too. Thank you so much for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. We'll be producing daily videos, and I'll see you next time.